either side. That's so real. It's like the most beautiful picture you've ever seen, but it's so vividly real. There are towns and people who live in this valley. It's a sacred space.
What are you wearing while you're standing there?
I'm wearing a shirt. It's, I think it's plaid, red and white plaid. Buttons down. Pants, boots. And I'm steering the boat.
As you're steering the boat, tell me, how does it feel as you're gliding in the water?
So familiar. Easy. It's cool in the air, but the sun is shining. And I know what I'm doing.
Sounds beautiful and peaceful. Just relaxing on your boat. What is it you are doing? You mentioned you know what you're doing. What are you doing?
I'm moving people through the valley. I take them to where they want to go. And I'm also just enjoying this place. Doing what I do affords me to be where I love. Nature is a great comfort.
And in this body, do you feel male or female in that body?
I feel like a man.
And describe what it is, and you say you move people. Say more. What is your job there? What do you do for these people?
I run a ferry. So I'm a transporter.
Where are the people going?
There's a lot of little towns. They need to get to different places. I know the way.
Sounds like a really good job and role. You make a difference for everybody there. Do you love what you do?
I do.
And how long have you been doing what you do?
Most of my life.
And how old do you feel in that body?
Like my 40s. 45.
What do they call you?
I say Sergio.
Sergio. And so when I call you Sergio, does that resonate?
It does.
Sergio. So where are you going on this beautiful day after you work on the ferry? Then what happens?
I go home.
And who's home? Is there anyone that lives in the home with you?
My wife. I say we have two kids. One of her parents lives with us, I believe her mother. It's warm, and there's a meal being cooked over the fire.
You smell it?
I can smell it. I think it's some kind of lentil bean stew.
Nice. And so as you be with your wife, look into her eyes. So the eyes are the seat of the soul. Do you recognize her?
Yeah.
And who is she?
I think it's my mother.
And just connect in with your wife's heart and her soul. How does that experience feel, Sergio, as you connect in with the love of your wife?
It feels good. We have a simple life.
Mm-hmm.
It's peaceful.
Mm-hmm.
We have everything we need.
How does it feel knowing that you've provided all that for your family?
Feels good.
Mm-hmm. And your children, are they there?
They're there.
Mm-hmm. Connect in with them and look into their eyes. And do you recognize them?
Not at the moment.
That's okay. So there you are, having this lovely meal, and you mentioned that your wife's mother also lives with you. Is she there with you?
She's here.
Mm-hmm. And connect in with her. As her eyes are the seat of the soul. And do you recognize her as anybody?
I think she might be my father.
Mm-hmm. And connecting in with that love. How would you describe the love and the family within your home? How does it feel, that family?
The love is strong. We live in a small and kind of quaint home.
Mm-hmm.
We're close to the earth.
When you say close to the earth, say more. What do you mean, close to the earth?
Almost like the floor is there's a dirt floor. But it's clean and simple, and we have everything we need.
Beautiful. And do you live in the town?
I live outside of the town.
And so, Sergio, going to go ahead and leave that scene and move you to the next most important day in your life where an important event occurred. Go ahead and leave that scene, Sergio, and move forward. Be there now and describe what you're feeling or seeing.
That there's an accident. And I don't die, nearly drown, but I'm injured in some way.
Tell me about the accident, Sergio. What happened?
I think the weather turns and I can't see. And for some reason, I'm in the water. Visibility's poor and it's cold, and I make it out and someone finds me. I think my leg is injured.
Look down at your leg and describe what has happened to your leg.
There's an injury to the knee. And it heals, but it's always, I can't work the way I did before.
How does it feel knowing you can't work the way you did before?
It's difficult.
How so?
I'm no longer independent. And my family suffers.
How so? How are they suffering?
Like, we're hungry.
Are you able to, you have to do less traveling with people, or what happens to your fairy business? What's happening as a result of this injury?
I can't work. And eventually my son starts to learn, and he starts to drive the boat.
How old is your son?
He's young. maybe 10.
So he's having to go to work now in order to support and help. Then what happens, Sergio?
I think I heal and I'm able to work, but not like before. And we live a simple life.
So let's leave that scene, Sergio, and move to the next important event that happens in that lifetime. Be there now.
I think it's my death. I'm older. And everyone's around me.
When you say everyone, who all is around you?
My wife. My son, my daughter. A few friends.
What's happened to you, Sergio?
I'm sick and it's my time.
How old do you feel?
I'm in my 60s.
It's your time?
It's my time to go.
As you look around your family, what are they saying and sharing to you?
They love me. There's sadness. There's questions about the future, but mostly love.
So there's questions about the future?
There's questions about the future of my family. I worry. I want to make sure they'll be okay.
How will you do that?
By trusting.
So Sergio, I want you to go ahead and take your last breath in that lifetime. Take your last breath and we're going to have you rise up above that body. And tell me, Sergio, when you're looking down on your body, and you're out of the body.
I'm old and somewhat frail. I'm tall and skinny. White hair and a white beard. And I'm out of that body now and it doesn't really appeal to me.
The body. And as you look down on that lifetime, Sergio, what was the lesson? Because every life has a lesson and a purpose. What was the lesson of that lifetime?
The lesson was to be a provider, to be depended on, to help others, and then to learn how to let go of that role and to accept the body's limitations and to trust.
What was the purpose of learning all of that for your soul? To learn all of those things. What was that purpose?
To explore the different lessons, different roles we can inhabit.
And you mentioned you were going to make sure your family's future was good. How will you do that now, Sergio, that you're on the other side? How will you be able to impact their life that way?
I plant little seeds.
How do you plant those seeds?
It's little discoveries. Along the way.
What do you mean you plant them? How do you plant them?
Mostly through nature. There's signs. And guide them.
Is there any way that you plant them within them or in your family members? How do you do that?
I'm waiting on a path, and my son needs reassurance and strength. And I'm there as a bird. And he sees me and he knows that he's doing the right thing. He's making the right choice.
How does that feel for you to be with him in that moment?
It feels really nice. It's a type of love that brings a tear of joy. That's like that.
Does he know that you're there?
He does.
That's so beautiful.
It does.
And Sergio, when you transitioned out of that body, who was there to greet you that day?
Everyone.
And who is everyone? Describe what it was like when they all greeted you.
Come into this open space. For me in this life, it's a field. We're walking. And everyone comes to meet me. And there's so much joy. So much love. We're hugging and laughing.
What is their message to you on that day? What do they say to you?
It's good to be here with you. It's a celebration. A party. There's great satisfaction in having lived a life to completion and coming home.
It's great. So I want you just to allow yourself to be in all that love and that celebration, Sergio. Breathing in and taking in all of those accomplishments of that lifetime. The abilities that you have to continually support your family, even though you've transitioned. So just to take all that in and breathe it in. And now we're going to leave that lifetime, allowing Sergio to find his way and find his path. We're leaving that lifetime now and moving you to the next most important lifetime. Moving you into that lifetime and asking you to be there now and describe the first impressions.
I'm a young woman.
Describe what you're wearing as that beautiful young woman.
I'm in simple clothes, and it's hard times. They're tattered and dirty.
What are simple clothes? Describe them.
It's like a provincial. I feel like I'm in France. It might even be during the time of the revolution. It's like a white smocked shirt with lacing to close the front. Brown long skirt. I have flat shoes, easy for walking.
Are you with anyone?
Right now I'm moving through the street. It's in a gray and cobblestones. It's kind of a gray day. There's a lot of gray.
It's a day or night?
It's dusk. I'm going somewhere.
How old does your body feel?
I feel young. 18.
What do they call you there?
Mildred.
Mm-hmm. So if I call you Mildred, does that resonate?
If it's not Mildred, it's M.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe Mary.
Mary. If I call you Mary, does that resonate with you?
That feels better than Mildred.
Mary. Mm-hmm. Mary, where are you going?
I'm working my way through the streets. It's dusk. And I'm on my way. I'm on my way to a meeting.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to get there before it gets dark.
Mm-hmm. Who are you meeting?
There's a group.
Mm-hmm.
We're talking about what's going on in the city. We're organizing. It's kind of a secret.
Oh, what are you organizing?
We're underground. We can't tell people. We're part of this faction. There's a revolution going on.
Mm-hmm.
People are angry.
Why are they angry?
People are suffering.
Mm-hmm. What are you suffering from?
Hunger.
Mm-hmm. Why is that happening? Describe what's happening in your world currently. What's going on?
There's an imbalance.
Mm-hmm.
Some people have a lot while others have nothing.
Mm-hmm. What's your role in this? Where are you headed in this group that you're communicating with? What are all of you going to do?
I'm a courier. I'm a messenger.
Mm-hmm.
I work in a house. And they can't know. But I carry messages back and forth.
Mm-hmm. Who do you carry them to?
There's a nobleman who wants to see change. But he can't openly voice it.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm connected through my family to leaders of the organization, of the movement.
Mm-hmm.
And I carry messages back and forth. There's a lot of hiding. That's where this feeling of...
Yeah, what is the feeling that's coming up for you?
The feeling of... as I carry these messages, as I work in the underbelly, I can't let people know. I can't get caught.
Mm-hmm. How's that feel?
It's a little scary.
Mm-hmm.
But also important work.
Mm-hmm. Where does that feeling live in your body, Mary?
In the chest. Mm-hmm. In my heart.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. How's your chest and heart feeling in this moment as you know you're carrying these secrets?
It feels alive.
Mm-hmm.
And as I breathe into it, I let it flow.
Mm-hmm.
It's heavy, but I let it flow.
Does it have a color?
It's kind of a mauve with purple.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe a touch of gold.
Mm-hmm. In that moment of that feeling, as you're walking through these streets carrying those secrets, what can you do to release that tension or that fear that's in your body in that moment?
I have to take deep breaths.
Mm-hmm.
I have to wear a face that says, I'm not afraid.
And are you afraid?
A little.
What will happen if you're caught?
I'll be thrown into prison, maybe even killed.
Your family knows that you do this?
They encourage it.
They encourage it. They're part of that movement.
Mm-hmm.
And you mentioned that your family is a group of leaders. What is your family's role in the community, in the city, as these leaders? What do they do?
We we're not super poor. I think we have a profession. It's kind of a front for the work that we're doing.
Mm.
I want to say that maybe it's a trade.
Mm-hmm.
I see maybe stone,
mm.
or cloth.
Mm-hmm.
So we're relatively respected.
Mm.
People come to us for services.
Mm-hmm.
But in the back rooms at night, we gather. We meet. There's candlelight. Sometimes we speak in whispers.
And other times you just speak what?
Other times we pretend like everything's fine. And we go about the daily life. But our mission, our goal, is to stir things up.
So Mary, I'm gonna go ahead and leave that scene and move you to the next most important event in that lifetime. Good job, be there now. Describe what's happening around you on that day, in that moment.
I'm 38.
Mm-hmm.
Aged.
Mm-hmm.
You have a child.
Mm-hmm.
I don't see the husband or the father. We're in our home.
What happened in the revolution? You didn't get caught.
I survived.
Mm-hmm. What happened?
There's kind of a satisfaction to that.
Mm.
A lot of people died.
Did they? People in your family?
Some of the people in my family.
Where's your husband?
He's not there.
As in he died or he's...
I don't know if he stuck around.
I want you to go ahead. I'm going to count from 3 to 1. When I get to 1, you'll know everything that's gone on from that time of 18 to this time. 3, counting down, connecting in. 2, going deeper. 1, and connecting in to that soul even deeper, Mary. What happened between those days? What all went on? And where's your husband?
I'm a very strong person in this life.
Mm-hmm.
Very resilient.
Mm-hmm.
I don't believe in feeling sorry for yourself.
Mm.
My husband was killed.
Mm-hmm.
Not in a public way. It was just in the streets.
A scuffle. And how did he die?
I think he was wounded.
Mm-hmm.
And he died.
I want you to connect in with your husband. And look into his eyes. As the eyes are the seat of the soul. Do you recognize him?
I think it's James.
Mm-hmm. Connect in with him fully. Fill his soul, connecting in with yours. And what was that relationship like?
It was open and honest.
Mm-hmm.
We worked together.
Mm-hmm.
We had the same drive and passion and calling.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't really allow myself to grieve.
Mm.
There wasn't time for that.
Mm-hmm.
I had a child and times were intense.
And Mary, is now the time to grieve the loss of that husband. Mm-hmm. Allow yourself to feel that. You've been so strong in that lifetime. Allow yourself to release any tension or pain or sadness that you're feeling. And where does that reside in your body?
It rises from my stomach into my chest, onto my shoulders.
Let it on up and out. Imagine that grief and it has wings. Let it release out of your body. How does it feel as you release that sadness and that grief of the loss of your partner?
It feels very free. Like I've left that body. I'm above it.
You're above that body now.
I'm above the town. I can see all around.
What ended up happening to you in that lifetime, Mary? How did you pass?
I grew old. I died of old age. My child took care of me.
Do you recognize your child as you connect in with those eyes?
I think it was Ellie. She was a little boy. She had golden hair. Gold brown. Piercing eyes. And she inherited our strength and resilience.
And Mary, what was the lesson of that lifetime?
As a helper, we were needed in whatever small way to make change. The personal lesson was about strength. It was about carrying on each day, even though terrible, difficult things can happen. We have a duty to live. There's a lot of duty in that life.
What was the purpose of your soul learning that duty to live?
There's a sense of honor and working with others. Carrying out a mission. And in all honesty, it was kind of fun.
It was fun.
It was exciting.
Sneaking around.
Yeah.
Knowing that you were making a difference. And did you accomplish the things you set out to accomplish in that lifetime?
Yes, I did.
How does that feel?
Feels good.
What did you look like in that lifetime?
Long black hair. I turned gray as I got older. I was kind of stout. As a young woman, I was fair and healthy, long and delicate. But as I aged, I got thicker. And I didn't really care about my looks. It wasn't very important to me.
Good. Do you feel you shined your light in that lifetime?
I did.
What color did you shine it?
It was blue.
How did that blue light impact people when you shined your light? How did it impact those around you? What would happen to them?
I was very curt and to the point, and I didn't mess around. And always Sometimes it took people by surprise. They got a kick out of me. I was very spunky.
Good. And so, Mary, who came to see you when you transitioned out of that body? Who arrived? Who greeted you? Take a look around.
Something to do with my lungs. And I'm laying in the bed. And I see my mother. I see guides, mm-hmm. and angels.
They're all around your bed as you're transitioning.
They're definitely encircling me.
Mm-hmm.
There's a, like they formed this oval shape around me. And locked in light, they help me pass.
Mm. What do they do to your lungs as you're passing and transitioning over?
They're almost lifted out.
Mm-hmm.
And they're infused with this kind of washed away.
Mm-hmm.
That was just necessary so it didn't get carried over.
Mm-hmm.
That didn't need to happen again.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, they're lifted out and cleaned. And then they just kind of dissipate because I don't need them anymore.
So let's go ahead and take the final breath there. Lifting you up and out of that body. Do those guides and angels have any final words to share with you at that time that they lifted you out of that body?
I think there's, they're very proud of me.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of just this clean, white, cleansing light.
Hmm. How's it feel as you stand inside of that light?
It's like being on top of a mountain.
Mm-hmm.
There's a cool, crisp wave of air, mm-hmm. moves all around you. And there's no weight. Mm. I'm just kind of floating. And it feels almost like a tunnel or an orb, but it's all around you.
Are you able to go into that tunnel or orb?
Now that I see it, I realize that it goes up or over or sideways. It's going somewhere.
Let's go. Take me through. Where are we going? As we leave that lifetime of Mary behind, let's go for a ride in that tunnel.
Straight into the city. We're in the place that we call heaven.
What does it look like?
Beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
We're in the main city.
Mm-hmm.
Where all the buildings are. There's many avenues and a lot of business and activity that takes place here.
What kinds of things take place there in the main city of what we call heaven?
It's a place where we go. There's many different buildings. They all have different purposes.
Mm-hmm. Where do you go after that lifetime?
I think I go straight to the hall. It's where the wisdom is kept.
The Hall of Records?
We go to the Hall of Records. There's some research I want to do.
Mm-hmm. What are you researching?
I think there was some clarification, and then for from the last life, but it's also relevant to the next life. And I don't need a lot of, I want to say coddling. I guess I'm just really sharp from still from this life. I don't need a lot of coddling. I just get straight to business.
Good.
I get there and I
How's your soul feel?
Good.
Mm-hmm.
It's good to be home.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm ready. I'm already ready.
Mm-hmm. I have business. How long have you been home? In Earth years.
Mm-hmm.
What would we call it?
Like 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
But not long.
Mm-hmm. And so you're preparing for this next lifetime.
I am.
Mm-hmm. What will that be?
Let's see. I think I'll be a man.
Mm-hmm. What will you be doing as that man?
There's work.
Mm-hmm.
Physical work.
Mm-hmm.
I think I'll be working in the field.
How do you decide what lessons you want to learn as that man? What's next? How do you come up with that plan?
I'm working with my guides.
Mm-hmm.
We do a life review.
Mm-hmm.
And they're just there to help me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm the one who's deciding
mm-hmm.
how I did and what I learned. Just reflecting. And based on that review, I choose what's next.
So what is next in that lifetime?
Well, I was really strong and dependable in that last life. And I think I'm seeking the opposite. Since I was so strong and I feel so confident in that, I want to learn what it's like to be and to have trouble.
What kind of trouble will you be creating for yourself?
I can almost just kind of see it, like jump into it.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a very happy life or eventful life. Just a lot of work.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of toiling and working, and my body's along, and it's like I can already jump ahead, kind of frail. And I've spent most of my life just working in the fields for someone else. I'm not particularly connected to the earth or to spiritual senses. I'm just kind of there and surviving.
What is the point and purpose of a soul to learn that kind of lesson?
It's well-rounded. Helps you.
Well-rounded.
You get the perspective of both sides.
Mm-hmm.
You want to know both sides.
Mm-hmm. What do we do with that information? I mean, what does a soul do once we learn that information? What is the purpose of the point? Where are we taking that information?
Oftentimes, when we're not living a life, we're helping on the other side.
Oh.
And these lives and the experiences we have help us to be guides or to act as conduits. We send our insight and our inspiration to others. And if we're well-rounded and we know both sides of the coin, then we are more able. We have great compassion. We know the suffering and we know the love, so we can more easily help and assist others.
And is that something that you do on a regular basis, is assist others?
As one of my preferences, yes.
As a soul, what do you look like?
Sparkly.
Mm-hmm. Are you female or male energy, or are you a non-gender energy?
I lean towards the feminine.
Mm-hmm.
I embody many of the characteristics that the mother shares.
Mm.
That's one of my strengths.
Mm-hmm.
Nurturing, loving,
mm-hmm.
helping.
Mm-hmm. And in this current lifetime that Lauren is living, how do you impact her in that lifetime? How does all of what you've learned assist her now?
She can't help but be the mother.
Mm.
She always has been.
Mm-hmm.
Her mother used to say, "You're not the mother." But she was and is.
Mm-hmm. What is her purpose in this lifetime?
It's to awaken that love in others and herself. In herself, it's a deeper, she's preparing.
What is she preparing for?
For a role.
Mm-hmm. Is this a role that she gets to know about today?
She steps into that role. She'll be acting as a guide, and she'll be channeling. She'll be channeling in this lifetime, but she'll be channeling in the future as a spirit.
Mm.
She'll be passing on information, discoveries,
mm-hmm.
energy to a multitude of people.
Mm-hmm. In this current lifetime.
In this current lifetime and the next.
Ah, very good. In terms of her being an artist and her beauty that she has chosen, why did she choose both the beauty and being the artist?
She's always been the artist.
Mm-hmm.
And she's able to see. She talked about the Akashic Records.
Mm-hmm.
Wanting to see the overview. She does that often.
Mm-hmm.
And it happens in these beautiful, beautiful ways. And she's meant to translate it. She doesn't have to exactly. It's not about being exact.
Mm.
It's a translation.
Mm-hmm. You're saying she has the ability to do that now?
She's currently doing it.
And as we connect in with you as her higher self in this session today, what are ways that she can connect deeper in and really expound on that gift?
She needs to trust and not be in a hurry.
Mm.
It's unfolding and it's time.
Mm-hmm.
It's important to just be in the moments, to fully learn the lessons each moment has,
mm-hmm.
and presents.
Beautiful. I want to go ahead I know we're already asking questions, and I'm assuming we have permission to ask more questions since we are here with you. I'd like to go ahead and go over these questions that she's brought forth today, if that is okay.
With joy.
With joy, good. So her father passed away last week. And after scheduling this appointment, and she's curious of the coincidences of that. And what messages does he have, if anything, to share at this time?
He has been with her always. And it was actually quite a relief. His passing was easy.
Mm.
He felt so free.
Mm-hmm.
And just took to it like a fish in water.
Mm-hmm.
He really liked a fish, you see, so
mm-hmm.
there's a fun joke. He is really taking this time to radiate and heal, and there's just this sense of joy and expansion. There's a lot of light, sunshine, this gold light. And he's exactly where she thought he was, where she went to see him.
Mm-hmm.
He's on the water. He's mm-hmm. spending a lot of time there. He's fishing, but it's not really, he doesn't, you know, not to catch. Mm-hmm. It's just
the experience.
It's the experience. There's a mm-hmm. lot of pleasure.
What was his choice in having multiple sclerosis in this lifetime? It impacted their family pretty much. What was the purpose of that lesson for all of them?
He's a really ambitious soul.
Mm.
And maybe, to his own admission, too ambitious. But he wanted to really leap. He wanted to leap ahead.
Mm.
And he has all those limitations, the being so confined, and even losing sight of higher self. He was able to return and to learn what is most important. This love that we have, that we share, that is timeless.
Mm.
And to live our lives knowing that, to practice it in your daily life, that is the most important thing. It is the crowning achievement.
Beautiful. She wanted to see the higher overview of the structure of heaven and creation, and the universe, but it sounds like you've sent her there. But what more would you like to show her or share with her today about that?
It's much like she thought, and like she thought, it's more complex than she can quite know at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
But there are many spheres. They go up and down in every direction.
Mm-hmm.
It's an expanse.
Mm-hmm.
Why not? The branches, the threads, the stories, the realms. It's difficult because as we expand, sometimes we forget.
Mm.
But it's quite simple because we all know we're all one.
Mm-hmm.
And there's nothing that you can't know. It's just when you're ready.
Mm. Why do we forget?
It's more fun that way.
That's a good answer. This is just the game.
It's more fun.
Mm-hmm. And yeah, and I think you might have answered this, but she wants to know the purpose of living the lives that we do, the growth and the experience. there's any more you want to shed light on that for her.
There's this analogy that we're all perfect. There's really, but we have infinity. And it's like, as we've chosen to be individual souls as a part of the whole, there's like a crystal diamond rainbow, many facets, many. It's almost like the structure of creation itself.
Mm-hmm.
It's just cavernous, and we polish, we shine up all these different parts. And it's a pleasure to do. There's nothing like doing a job and doing it well. And in a sense, not to diminish, you know, the duality, but there's such pleasure in cleaning house, in cleaning the windows for our soul to manifest. And as we do that here, we free ourselves up for a more untethered, less dense experience as we go forward.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful. She'd like to clarify her current life's purpose and what major lessons she has to learn.
Her life's purpose is, to boil it down rather simple, it's to be the messenger of love. And it's as she thought, it can be simple and an act of kindness, or just to be there for someone you love. But the work that she's doing as an artist will resonate for the future.
Mm-hmm.
And people will stare at it and have experiences. They will be transitioned or elevated, and they will allow themselves to untether. They will allow themselves to get lost.
Mm-hmm.
So that they're not so much of this body, but in a sense of wonder. And relinquishing form, letting go of form.
When she creates this art, is there light activation that goes through into those pieces such that when people look at them, they're activated in some way?
They are portals.
Mm.
Especially the work that's begun as her father began, has readied himself to pass.
Mm-hmm.
The beginning of that passing was the awakening of this work. And it's beautiful, as it's, she is not attaching to it. She's allowing the flow and not identifying with what happens. And so the channel is open, and it will progress and grow. And this will be the way that she prefers to work.
Beautiful. That's awesome. So you're encouraging her to continue what she's embarking on in this moment, what's unfolding and opening up through her.
Absolutely.
Wonderful.
It will lead it will be to this spiritual growth she hopes for and the people that she needs to meet on the way.
She'd like to clearly communicate with you, her guides, masters and angels, in a more direct and clear way. How can she best achieve that level of communion after today?
She's rather good at it. She needs to trust. She needs to trust and take advantage, as she knows, of the still, small moments. A long and large journey can take place in a small amount of time. So, a lot can be accomplished with just a moment. That's all you need.
Who are her master guides? Who is she connected with?
She has a circle. There are three leaders in the group who step forward.
Can she see them now?
Yes. There are two male energies and feminine light. She's heard them before. She knows when. They work with her and through her. And many times, people in her life, she will act as a channel for their messages, so they can receive their messages. And she usually knows it.
Good.
We encourage her to embrace stepping aside, to be in your body, but to allow yourself float out of it. You can be both.
Who is it we're speaking with today?
Her higher self.
Good, thank you.
My pleasure. The angels are also present.
Anyone's in particular?
She works with Saint Germain. She sees the violet flame and the purple and the lilac. The tricolor flame, the mother. Michael is often by her side. And then they work as a group when they're needed. There's a lot of work to be done.
When you say there's a lot of work to be done, can you say more on that?
We're currently doing the work. We're all a part of this wave. This cleansing. She is very connected to the earth. She chose her birth date. It's no coincidence. Easter Sunday, the Christ consciousness, Earth Day. The time, the day. That's just a sign that that is part of the work that she has to do. We are clearing. We are becoming lighter.
Beautiful. I was going to ask about her career, but I think you've answered this. She feels she procrastinates and has a fear of success. Where does that come from? And can we remove that from her today? I know you have the power to do that, but where does that come from? And does she need that anymore?
There are some roots in this lifetime, but there have been multiple lifetimes where we are judged.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes we believe it.
Mm-hmm.
And it is coming up now because it needs to go.
Mm-hmm. And can you clear that from her today?
With pleasure.
And how will you be doing that today so she can hear it on the audio?
It will come in the form of the elements, a great wind and a wave. There will be a light you can feel. And she's feeling it now. It's...
How is she feeling that in her body?
There's a lifting.
Mm-hmm.
Like molecules evaporating. Mm-hmm. And they are.
Mm-hmm.
The cells, the energy that is trapped is releasing.
Bubbling up like 7-Up.
Bubbling up.
Good. Let's have all that bubble up and out today.
Absolutely.
And cleanse and clear her today.
For us all.
She'd like to increase her psychic intuitive abilities and strengthen the ability to astral travel. And she wishes to connect with love, light, and the wisdom of the Great Spirit in everything she does. What are some beautiful ways that she can do that? And... she feels called to do work in that field. Should she? What is the calling? And how does she unlock these gifts?
She is on the path.
Mm-hmm.
Do not worry too much about the details.
Mm-hmm.
They will come. There are gifts. They will be given.
Mm.
Stay open. And there are teachers and helpers along the way. Some she has already met. The work has already begun. Meditation.
Mm-hmm.
Stillness.
Mm-hmm.
Yoga.
Mm-hmm.
Untethering from the body and floating.
Mm-hmm.
That is how you travel.
Mm-hmm. Good. Anything else you want to say about that before we move on to other questions?
We're all given guidance. We can never get too far off the path.
Mm-hmm.
It's just not allowed.
Mm-hmm.
So the gifts and the sparks, it's just important. Allow your heart to be open.
Mm.
And believe that you're worthy. You are worthy. And in so many ways, in the selfless way, which you're comfortable with, it's not about you, it's about us all. So why judge?
Mm-hmm.
Why impose the limits? You're so capable of love for everything. Please extend it to yourself.
Mm.
Because you are a part of that. And that is one of the lessons you are to learn.
So beautiful. I love the part about extend that to ourselves.
It's very important.
Yes.
And as people, souls, who are doing this work, it is one of the main lessons. You can see all the beauty and all the love all around you. You must see it in yourself. You must You must forget yourself, and in doing so, you become yourself.
Mm.
You become all that you love.
Mm.
And release any tension anywhere in your body or in the field surrounding you, just with your breath.
That's beautiful. Just with your breath. She'd like to also look at money and finances, self-worth, confidence. Is she ready to let go of this story today?
She absolutely is. And a lot of that was tied into the lessons that she needed to learn.
Mm-hmm.
And with her father's passing, she is correct. There is a, like a bubble.
Mm.
It popped.
Mm-hmm. Is that due to lineage, or what does that do to?
As the soul group, they all needed to feel, they all needed to feel that.
Mm-hmm.
There was no escaping.
Mm-hmm.
There's been some attempts to escape the lessons with the material,
mm-hmm.
for sure. But that just didn't, and the focus had to be the experience. You had to go through it. That's all there was to it. And now that you're moving into this new phase, it's as you thought. It's, you will not need to work very hard.
Mm.
There will be, there are built in people and helpers along the way, and they are waiting.
Mm.
And why not do some work? Why not do some work and promote yourself? Promote, because it's not, don't worry, it's not about you. It's not about your ego. It's about sharing the message, which is why you're here. So just let go of worrying so much about what people will think or judge, or you got this.
Mm-hmm.
And the ego can be of service, so try not to be so hard on it.
Mm-hmm. It's a partner.
It's a partner.
When we learn how to use it.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Stop blaming the ego.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You can have a relationship with it now that you are there, and there is no danger of slipping backwards.
Mm.
You can move forward as a partner.
Mm-hmm. I love that. That's awesome. Does she have unresolved karma to work through in this lifetime?
Yeah, there are definitely a few things.
Anything you want to share with her right now? Or
it's mostly, she hasn't so much created any big new karma to work off.
Mm-hmm.
But there have been moments, some small, but she knows. She remembers and she feels guilty. And they're there to teach us the lessons. And that karma, the other person that you're involved in wants to let go too.
Mm.
And that memory that keeps surfacing, it's just there to remind you to let go.
Mm-hmm.
They have forgiven you if you will forgive yourself.
Mm-hmm.
It's as simple as that.
Mm. Forgive ourselves.
Forgive yourself.
All will be forgiven.
Mm-hmm. Be aware. Pay attention when it comes up. And just be kind to yourself. And allow yourself to be free.
Mm-hmm.
you can work more easily in that way.
Okay. She'd like to access the Akashic Records. For the greatest good of herself and others. Is this a gift that you will be having unfold for her such that she'll be able to offer this more with people?
She can enter the library.
How?
She can do so by taking herself there with the visualization, with the artist's mind of embellishing and allowing the dream. Because that's a lot of how it functions and exists. It's alive. As she tries to get in, that in and of itself is a part of it. Mm-hmm. We are plugged in always.
Mm-hmm.
In her waking life, there's a kind of a limited access. Like, she can go and she can share some of its knowledge. She can create awareness about it, which will be important. Others should know that it exists. So they can begin to dream. In her dream state, that is where she would be allowed sort of this like research, like a library card, like time to sit and dig. And the clearing, the work that she's doing will determine how much she can carry back. So continue that clearing and continue your dreams. It will develop and unfold, and later in life you can possibly more easily just walk through. But it is a journey.
Okay. Why did you show Lauren those two lifetimes today? What was the purpose of you showing her those?
One, the first life was to show that where the mind wanders, it wants to go. So she was just trying to visualize this beautiful place and go somewhere nice.
Yep.
But there's a connection. There's always a connection.
We dropped right into a lifetime, which is not usually what we do.
Yeah.
And I heard you guys say, turn on the recorder.
She thought, oh, let's just go somewhere nice.
Yes.
So that was to show that you should really pay attention to your calling, to your passion, to your beauty. We so need that right now. So as you are called to a place, a song, a book, a melody, what have you, it is for a purpose. There is something there, and we should be very clear that we should not judge this expansion, this modality, this way of being. It's honestly easier than we think. And that was the point. It was also just to touch base with a few, just to show you've been here before with other people. And oh my gosh, what humor. And her mother being her wife.
Right.
You know, what? That's so funny for her, because she feels such a struggle and a distance. It didn't exist in that life. So that was also part of the purpose.
Just a lesson.
Just a lesson.
Anything you want to share about that next life?
That next life was to show that all lives have implications and power, and we are all capable of strength. We feel a sense of duty, and it's mainly connected to higher sources. We don't always understand it.
Yes, yes, yes.
But there is a call and a purpose. And that lifetime, she was clear and she was strong and she did not hesitate. So to show her that, in light of kind of some of the more sensitive sides of herself in this life, was grounding. That you can be this stout, austere, powerful woman who, you know, navigates the murky streets of a revolution and lives to tell the tale, even if you don't.
That's kind of where we are right now.
Absolutely.
So she can do that.
Absolutely. And it is exciting.
Very exciting.
Yeah.
Love it. So I'd like for you guys to do a body scan, or for I'd like you to do a body scan with her now. She did have some aches and pains, but can you go ahead and do a body scan and let me know where she needs some clearing and some energy healing that we can provide her today, or that you can provide her today?
Absolutely. The sacral, the root chakra. It has been the doorway, it has been the passage. There has been some weakness around the family in this lifetime. And I invite you all to extend that chakra down and into the earth on which you stand, and extend it all the way down and all the way back up, allowing it to rise all the way through all the chakras we know and up into the ones that we're not even aware we have, into your higher self, so that thread of light, that flood of light, can be open and to spin the wheels. As you do this exercise, each time more healing occurs.
Got it. And what healing can you provide in terms of light on her today to cleanse and clear that out, if any? And can you describe it to her so that she has it on the recording?
Absolutely. We start with hands, the laying on of hands, invisible and seen. When your body calls you to stop, please stop. Surrender and listen to what it is saying to you. You don't always need an hour or a day. It can be as simple as the small moment. But we will be sending a rainbow. A cocktail, a mixture. It's hard to describe the colors, because they're shimmery, they're colors within colors, and they change. We'll be sending that to you all, but in this special request to Lauren, to do some of the release and healing that she will need. She needs this to do her work.
And can she feel that right now?
She can.
Mm-hmm. What does it feel like?
It rises, and the tightness mm-hmm. in the body
mm-hmm.
will begin to dissolve.
Good.
In the throat, in the head, around the base of the skull. This is going to clear the way for what we call, what you call Kundalini, mm-hmm. or the rising up and the wrapping around and the transmission of your light.
Good.
So just let it be.
Good. She mentioned some tightness around her neck that she fears that it could cause some illness at some point. Can you look in there and describe what's going on and what she needs to release to let go of that?
In this lifetime, the tightness is a result of being careful,
mm-hmm.
of having to hold back to survive.
Mm-hmm.
But it's okay now.
Mm-hmm.
You should definitely let it out.
Mm-hmm.
But there have been, in the past, there have been injuries to the throat. The throat was slit. There was a drowning.
Mm-hmm.
There have been many things.
Mm-hmm.
So,
can that cellular memory be dissolved and released today?
Absolutely.
And by what percentage?
I'm going to say 75%.
Today? And how many days until we can get it 100% complete for her, or weeks?
With the willingness
mm-hmm.
and the use of her voice,
mm-hmm.
we can do this work in 3 months.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Good. Good. And I know you'll have her wide open over the next 3 days, and you'll continue to do that work on her while she's sleeping.
Absolutely.
And integrating that energy. She'd also talked about some pain in her lower back area and her hips. Was this all related to the root or in the sacral? And is there something else that you see in there?
It is related to the root, especially to bringing children into this world.
Mm-hmm. What's happening with that conscious thought?
I see
or subconscious thought.
I see the loss. In another life, I see there were no children. There was loss.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe even death.
Mm-hmm.
So there was a great strength in this life that she presented. But there was just this carryover.
Mm-hmm.
And she's used to carrying a lot of weight. But she needs to learn to breathe.
Mm-hmm.
Don't hold your breath as you're carrying the things you carry. Please give some to us. And remember to breathe.
Mm-hmm.
That's your connection.
Where else do you want to provide her some healing energy today? And by the way, the percentage on her back in the hip area, what is the percentage of pain that can be released and healed today?
It's almost complete,
mm-hmm.
but there will be a trigger
mm-hmm.
to remind her to stop. The trigger is there to remind you.
Mm. What will she need to stop doing?
Get out of your head and into your heart. You will know what to do when you get there. The figuring out of things.
Mm-hmm. Let that go.
Let that go.
The inevitableness of the human brain. Where else in her body, if anything, what else would you like to heal for her today? And if not, let me know when you're done with what you're doing on her.
Her third eye.
Mm-hmm. What's happening there?
It has been sensitive for a long time, and it has manifested in many ways.
Mm-hmm.
There has been an onslaught of release and even some fighting back. Mm-hmm. If fighting back is the right, just a more, I'd say, reaction.
Mm-hmm.
To the change.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes you feel like you've been hit across the face.
Mm-hmm.
Like you physically, like an energy has just, boom, hit you.
Mm-hmm.
So that has manifested a lot in her third eye. Mm-hmm. And in the glandular system, in...
What can you do to release and wash that off?
We will get on it. Mm-hmm. We will. It is being worked on. Mm-hmm. It is active. But I think that is the work that maybe requires a partnership.
Mm-hmm.
With her. She'll have to come to the table.
Mm-hmm.
And she'll have to co-create with us a plan. We will assist and we will unlock. It is already open.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that the belief and the willingness to trust,
mm-hmm.
herself,
yeah.
is going to do the healing.
Got
so
it.
It's up to her.
Got it. Excellent. Anything else you want to work on with her and her body?
We call to sit in nature.
Mm.
This is the most powerful healing agent,
mm-hmm.
that we have to offer, mm-hmm. in a tangible form.
Mm-hmm.
And the gifts are just... they're just right there. They will come to you.
So what would you require for her on a weekly basis in terms of hours? How many hours a week should she prescribe? What do you prescribe?
We are realistic and we understand the demands that she has in her life.
Mm-hmm.
But this work could even be done when you're going to bed. Mm-hmm. You know, it could be done while you're driving your car.
She can even just sit in the backyard with the kids.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
And be in that nature.
But I definitely feel we are calling to her to a place.
Mm.
She needs to go, and she's going to Colorado. She's going to Denver.
Mm-hmm.
She will be going to the mountains. She has, mm-hmm. wanted to go for a long time, and the opportunity just came up. Mm-hmm. It's happening, and she already is very excited about that and knows that's, mm-hmm. where she's supposed to go.
Mm-hmm.
So there is a lot of energy that, mm-hmm. will unlock.
Good. Before we wrap up, and are you complete with the body scan?
We are complete.
Are there any other things you'd like to leave her with today? And by the way, it's been an absolute pleasure speaking with you.
It has been a pleasure speaking with you, and we are so glad that everything lined up. We, yes. knew it would.
Yes, yeah. Anything else, any final words you'd like to leave her with today?
There is a symbol. There are a few symbols. There is a key.
Mm-hmm.
And you already have it. There is a locket. It is not physical. We just invite you to imagine it, what it might look like, and what you might see inside. And every time you do this, you will see what you need, something different. It's just a vehicle. It's fun. And you will find messages in this trinket, in this symbol. It can manifest in a different way. That's what came through at the moment.
Excellent. Excellent. Well, I definitely want to say thank you so much for being with us today and the work that you've done with her, as I know she's going to appreciate it.
Thank you so much.